So what is Google Earth Engine and why would anyone even need it? Basically, Earth Engine is a platform for scientific analysis and visualization of geospatial data sets for academic, non-profit organization, businesses and government users. Earth Engine hosts satellite imagery and stores it in a public data archive that includes historical Earth images going back to more than 40 years. So how is Google Earth different from Google Earth? Google Earth enables you to travel, explore and learn about the world by interacting with the virtual globe. You can view satellite images, maps, terrain, 3D buildings and many more. Having said that, the Earth Engine on the other hand is a tool for analyzing geospatial information. So you can analyze forest and water coverage, land use change, assess the health of agricultural fields, and among many other possible analyses. So what is Google Earth Engine? So as you can see, Google Earth Engine is a cloud computing platform for processing satellite imagery and other geospatial and observational data. So what is the main advantages of Google Earth Engine? It provides an access to a large database of satellite images and computational power needed to analyze those images. So rather than saving large datasets on your hard drive, you can access these detailed datasets on cloud environment. For an example, if you are conducting a research or an analysis that distributed around a continent or maybe globally, and you need to have landsat images. As an example, you are considering the land cover, land use change over a period of time in the globe. Without Google Earth Engine, you have to, if you are using a separate software, you have to download this software, and also, most importantly, you have to download the images. So just imagine if you are downloading gigabytes of images. With Google Earth Engine, you don't have to do that. In the Google Earth Engine, you can directly use those images in a cloud environment. So as you can see, the data catalog of Google Earth Engine have a variety of collection. For an example, the Landsat collection have images since 1972 to present day, including Landsat 1 to Landsat 8. So in the MODIS collection, you can get many image types for calculating or analyzing global snow cover, land surface temperature, and also surface reflectance. When you consider in the Sentinel collection, you can have both Sentinel-1 synthetic aperture radar data as well as the Sentinel-2 multispectral imaging data. So in the following figures, you can see some of the data sets that I have obtained from the Google Earth Engine catalog. Apart from that, there are many derived global data sets such as NDVI and EVI vegetation indices, which are useful in country-based and continental-based land use analysis. Also, you will have access to Aster data, nighttime lights, long-term look at the links to socio-economic trends. So in this slide, I have included some of the case studies done in the Google Earth Engine. So the first one is mapping global urban land cover. Very recently, in 2018, Google Earth Engine platform was used to map global urban land cover using high-resolution multispectral Landsat images. The results indicated that world's urban land area had increased by around 300,000 square kilometers between 1990 to 2010, reaching a global coverage of 0.63%. Interesting fact is that China, the United States, and India together contributed to almost 43% of the total increase of global urban land cover. So I have included the link in the description below So you can have this case study. So another case study that was interesting to conduct in Google Earth Engine is that mapping rural settlements using remote sensing dataset. So in 2020, Google Earth Engine platform was used to map rural settlements using multi-source remote sensing dataset in the Yangtze River Delta. Even though it has not been used widely as other remote sensing and GIS softwares like ArcGIS and ArcGIS, this is a very powerful platform to anyone who wishes to perform spatial dataset analysis. And in this course, we will further work on some of the common applications that can be carried out with Google Earth Engine and learn how to harness the power of Google Earth Engine for GIS and remote sensing. Why Google Earth Engine? Because there are plenty of softwares. For an example, we can use ArcGIS or QGIS, ArcGIS, many more. Google Earth Engine is a powerful spatial data analysis platform for performing common GIS tasks and also some of the advanced GIS tasks. And the main advantage, as I said before, it provides a large data set of satellite imagery and computational power need to analyze those images. It is also important to note that Google Earth Engine platform was introduced quite recently. And if you master the Google Earth Engine platform, you will definitely get an edge over the other candidate during college application or maybe job interviews. So in the first lesson, I will explain you how to get started with the Google Earth Engine, how to sign up, and also how to navigate the data sets that are available on Google Earth Engine. So in the section 2, I will explain you about Code Editor in the Google Earth Engine. So Code Editor can be known as the base of Google Earth Engine, and you will learn basic programming including JavaScript and Python. So if you have some experience in programming, then that is great. However, it doesn't matter if you are not familiar with programming, and I will add some contents to familiarize you with basic JavaScript and Python programming. In this section, I will also teach you how to add your own datasets into the Google Earth Engine, for an example, raster datasets or shapefiles. So in the section 3 and section 4, we'll start with very simple GIS operations such as zonal statistics, clipping and buffering, and move a bit advanced operations like threshold operations, arithmetic operations. Moving on to the section 5, in this section, we'll explore and manipulate spatial datasets with statistical tools. So in the section 6, in this section, you will learn about different Landsat sensors, conducting atmospheric corrections, pan sharpening, learn how to utilize Landsat optical data for land use and cover classifications. So in the section 7, I will demonstrate how we can utilize Sentinel-1 synthetic aperture radar or SAR datasets for flood inundation mapping. So in the final section, which is section 8, I will demonstrate how to read and visualize socioeconomic data and common remote sensing application related to forest cover loss. So stay tuned for the future videos.